Hey guys, Wells Knight here, bringing you a little bit of a Premiere Pro tutorial. I recently had a situation where I was trying to time something within one of my videos with sort of a stopwatch effect, and I was really struggling to figure out how to do it properly. There's a lot of tutorials out there about how to make use of the timecode effect in order to create a stopwatch. The problem was getting it to freeze or pause on the final time once you cross the finish line, so to speak. So I'm going to show you how to do that today now that I've got it all figured out, and hopefully it will be helpful. Now, I am going to assume that you do not know anything about the timecode effect. You may already know this, you may not, but we'll get to it. What you are going to need is you will need a transparent image, just a fully transparent PNG of something, and you will need, of course, the clip that you are trying to time. So let's just grab this and throw it down. This is the bit from the video where essentially in Minecraft I am flying an elytra course trying to get through it as fast as possible, and I wanted to time this. So the first thing that we will need to do is find where our timing begins. And for us, that's going to be when my feet leave the ground. So it looks like that is right about, let's see, right there. That looks about right. And that's where we're going to throw down our transparent image. So we are then going to just drag that over to here somewhere. And on the transparent image, we are going to apply the timecode effect. There's a few ways you can get to it. You can search for timecode. You can go under video effects, and it's under video all the way here at the bottom. Or, and this is something that I just highly recommend you do in general if you do a lot of video editing in Premiere, have a favorites folder for stuff that you will be using fairly frequently. And you can just put it there as well. So we'll just drag that onto the transparent PNG, and then we can configure this. And there's a few things we can do. Let's see. Looks like, what just happened? I changed something. I don't know what it did. But either way, it's fine. So we want to configure this. There's a few options. We have under your effect controls up here, when you have the transparent PNG selected, you've got position. This will allow you to move it around. You can also click on position and then drag it this way, like so. And we'll just put it down here. You can change the size, make it bigger, smaller, whatever. We'll just stick with the default of 20. Opacity will make it darker, or you'll see this like black box behind it. You can change that as well. We'll leave that where it was at the default. The field symbol is this little kind of football looking thing, and you can check or uncheck that. We will just leave it unchecked. And now we get into the important stuff. So, couple things. First of all, format. This is frames, feet and frames. This we're not going to mess with. We'll leave it on SMPTE. But timecode source, this is very important. So media just means where it would be in the overall clip, like in the entire video that you're creating. We don't want that. We want this to generate based off of either the generate method, which will be it'll start right at the beginning of this clip and you can put in whatever time you want, or you can also just change it to clip as well. We'll go generate so we can have it start at 0:00. But if we wanted this to start, say, 10 seconds in, we could do that, and then it would start with 10 seconds on the clock. So you can make use of this if you want to, for example, have a stopwatch start, pause it, and then have it resume again afterwards. That's where this starting timecode thing would come in handy. So let's just change this to 0 for now. And then we will go in and you'll see it is advancing. Now, the thing is, you may notice this run took about 30 seconds. And by the end of it, it has us at over a minute. For some reason, it is advancing twice as fast as I want it to, and that is not good. I don't know why it does this, but the easy fix is to select the clip, change this to 60 drop frame, and then change it back. And then it works fine. Don't ask me why that works, but it does. Anyway, so there we go. That's how you get the stopwatch effect. That's the easy part. Now we need to show you how to pause the stopwatch effect on your final time. So I know that this run took 28.40 seconds because I have already timed this out previously. So we will find the spot right there. 28.4 seconds. What we will then do is switch to our cut tool with the C key on your keyboard. Click right here, back to V to go back to select, delete this. So this is where we want our pause to be. What you then need to do is select just the transparent image that has the timecode effect applied to it, right click, and go to nest, and change this to whatever name you want to call it, run one, whatever. You need to nest the image. Then you can right click again and add a frame hold and drag this out for as long as you want it to go. We'll just drag it out all the way over here just to be ridiculous. So now you'll see we get our timer going normally, and then once it hits our final time, it just pauses there and stays on that time. And then if you want, you can apply transition effects or whatever to this. Maybe we throw a little fade out so that it will slowly disappear now that the run is concluded, or however you want to do it. So that's basically how it works. That's the trick. You need to have a transparent image, apply the time code effect to it, configure the time code, nest the transparent image, and then you can apply a frame hold to essentially pause the timer on the screen. So there you go. I hope that was very helpful for you. If you enjoyed the video, you know what to do. Links in the description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, my friends, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.